Hello students, welcome to the second video lecture of your subject Object-Oriented Methodology. Today we are going to learn about the major characteristics of object-oriented programming with their description. As you can remember, in our previous lecture we discussed about the characteristics of object-oriented programming. What are the characteristics of object-oriented programming? Let us remember that are objects, classes, data abstraction, data encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, overloading, dynamic binding, and message passing. As you know that all these things are interrelated to object-oriented programming. Without this, we cannot be able to perform object-oriented programming. First, we will study about object. What is it? And objects are the basic building blocks of our designing programs. It is a collection of data members, associated member functions. An object may represent as person, place, table, or for data. Each object is identified by a unique name, and each object must be member of a particular class. Like apple, orange, mango are the objects of class fruit. As you can see in this diagram that objects, it is a student object having the data member's name, registration number, and course. And what are the member functions used for this student object? The get data and display. As object is an entity that has state and behavior. Here, let me give you an example. A chair, pen, table, keyboard, bike, etc. are all objects because it can be physical or logical. An object can be defined as an instance of a class. An object contains an address and takes up some space in memory. Objects can communicate without knowing the details of each other's data or code. The only necessary thing is the type of message accepted and the type of response returned by the object. It means that without object, we cannot be able to do anything in Java, because it is the most important concept of Java. That's why its name is object-oriented programming. As the name suggests, objects are responsible for all the types of execution. In this object-oriented programming, we will learn about different types of objects and their interrelated classes. In object-oriented are the central idea behind OOP. As you know that it has a specific characteristics and behaviors. It represents the data of an object and behavior represent the functionality of an object. Next, we will go to what is class. The class can be made as user-defined and data types with the help of a class. It means that a class can be a user-defined data type. User-defined means a user can give any type, any name to a class. A class is a collection of objects, and you know that it is a logical entity. A class is a blueprint from which you can create an individual object. Without class, you cannot able to create object. And without object, you cannot able to execute the class. A class doesn't consume any space. Remember it. A class doesn't consume any space, but an object does. As you know that a class has identical properties, common behavior, and shared relationship. Once the class is defined, any number of objects can be created. Any number means you can create n number of objects inside a single class. A class can hold both data and functions. And data and functions are combined in different methods. A class are user-defined data types. For example, planets, sun, moon are members of class solar system. It means that solar system is a class and planets, sun, moon are the members of the class. Like you are the class, you are the pupils, you are the students belonging to class third semester of third semester, and the each student belongs to this class. Now we will discuss about the data abstraction, encapsulation and data hiding. What is data abstraction? Data abstraction refers to the process of representing essential features without including background details or explanations. Here, the datas are hidden. The internal datas are hidden and it shows only the functionality. For example, phone call. We don't know the internal processing, but we just attend the call and talk to everyone. In Java, we use abstract class and interface to achieve data abstraction. Without data abstraction, we cannot be able to do or hide any things. Now, what is data encapsulation? Data encapsulation is the binding of code and data together into a single unit, like a capsule. For example, a capsule, as you know that it is wrapped with different medicines. A Java class is an example of encapsulation. It contains a Java bean is fully encapsulated class because of all the data members are private here. It is also refers to the knowledge of information on dependency of another class. It arises when class are aware of each other. If a class has a detailed information of another class, then there is strong coupling. If it doesn't contain any data, then we use private and protected and public modifiers to display the visibility label of class, methods and fields. So there is no concrete implementation of coupling. Now we will discuss about the cohesion. Cohesion refers to the level of component which performs a single well-defined task. A single well-defined task is done by a highly cohesive method. The weakly cohesive method will split the task into separate parts. However, the java.util package is a weakly cohesive package because it has unrelated class and interfaces. There are many associations which are included in this, like one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one, and many-to-many. As you know that in data encapsulation, it hides the data and information together. It is a method which is used in object-oriented method programming to hide information with computer code. Next, inheritance. What is inheritance? Inheritance is a process by which one object can acquire and use the properties of another object. The existing class is known as base class and superclass, or the superclass. The new class is known as the derived class or subclass. The derived class shares some of the properties of base class. Therefore, a code from base class can be used by a derived class. Let me give you some examples. Like the features, the properties of your father comes to you. Means the genes that is inherited from your father comes to you. Your father is the superclass or the base class, but you belongs to the subclass or derived class. It means that the properties that is derived from the parent class comes to the base class through inheritance.